After the previous video in this series, several Christians sent verses of encouragement. Thank you for keeping your hearts focused on Jesus, the source of our joy and our hope. So let's take a moment and refresh with the Word of Life. John 16:33. These things I have spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace. In the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. King James. I have told you these things, so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble. But take heart, I have overcome the world. New International Version. Our hope is not in America. Our hope cannot be in military strength. Our hope must be in Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Hebrews 12:2. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter or finisher of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Jesus, who for the joy set before him, endured the cross. As the destruction of the end times looms large, hold fast to the truth. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Psalm 110, verse 1. The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet. Remember when Jesus used this very verse. Matthew 22:41. And the Pharisees, having been assembled together, Jesus questioned them, saying, what do you think concerning the Christ? Of whom is he son? They said to him, of David. So the Jewish Pharisees had been grilling Jesus, and Jesus decided to play, stop, the Pharisee. Keep one other thing in mind. Muslims say they believe that Jesus is the Christ. But because Islam is ignorant of the prophets, Muslims have no idea of what Christ even means. So Jesus asked a question about the Christ. What do you think concerning the Christ? Of whom is he son? They said to him, of David. That's a good place to begin a Socratic interrogation. That is the setup. He says to them, how then does David in spirit call him, meaning the Christ, Lord? Saying, the Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I place your enemies as a footstool for your feet. Here's the verse we saw earlier. The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I place your enemies as a footstool for your feet. Psalm 110:1. The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet. In the Hebrew, that is Jehovah, Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, the Tetragrammaton. In the Hebrew, that is La-Adonai. Both are commonly used for God. Clearly, Jesus, by usage and implication, infers that Psalm 110, verse 1, refers to the Christ. We can further conclude the Jewish leaders accepted this premise because they did not challenge the assertion. Psalm 110:1 therefore refers to Jehovah God speaking to the Christ, which David references as Adonai.
Danger, Will Robinson, danger!
And here comes the kicker, the cold water in the face of ignorant arrogance. If, therefore, David calls him Lord, how is he his son? How is he, the Christ, his, meaning David's, son? How is the Christ David's son? And no one was able to answer him a word. Nor did anyone dare from that day to question him any longer. If you call yourself Muslim, you need to watch this video over and over until you understand the following. Psalm 110:1 reveals Jesus, the Christ, the Messiah, the Messiah, is the Son of God. Think back a moment how we got here. Hebrews 12:2, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. We then looked at Psalm 110:1. The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet. Mark 12:36, speaking by the Holy Spirit, David himself declared, the Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I put your enemies under your feet. Matthew 26:64, you have said it yourself, Jesus answered. But I say to all of you, from now on, you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the Mighty One and coming on the clouds of heaven. Jesus, the Christ, the Son of Man. Mark 14:62, I am, said Jesus, and you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of power and coming with the clouds of heaven. Mark 16:19, after the Lord Jesus had spoken to them, he was taken up into heaven and sat down at the right hand of God. As the darkness grows, and it will grow darker, hold on to, hold fast to the truth. 2 Peter 1:16, for we have not followed cunningly devised fables when we made known unto you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but were eyewitnesses of his majesty. Matthew 16:27, for the Son of Man will come in his Father's glory with his angels, and then he will repay each one according to what he has done. John 8:24, that is why I told you that you would die in your sins, for unless you believe that I am he, you will die in your sins. Who are you? They asked. Just what I have been telling you from the beginning, Jesus replied. I have much to say about you and much to judge, but the one who sent me is truthful, and what I have heard from him I tell the world. They did not understand that he was telling them about the Father. So Jesus said, when you have lifted up the Son of Man, then you will know that I am he, and that I do nothing on my own, but speak exactly what the Father has taught me. Christians, you have learned the truth, that Jesus died for your sins. Hold on to the truth. 1 John 3:11, this is the message you have heard from the beginning. We should love one another. Do not be like Cain, who belonged to the evil one and murdered his brother. And why did he slay him? Because his own deeds were evil, while those of his brother were righteous. 1 John 3:13, so do not be surprised, brothers, if the world hates you. We know that we have passed from death to life because we love our brothers. The one who does not love remains in death. Everyone who hates his brother is a murderer, and you know that eternal life does not reside in a murderer. By this we know what love is. Jesus laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers. Luke 6:22. Blessed are you when people hate you, and when they exclude you, and insult you, and reject your name as evil, because of the Son of Man. Rejoice in that day, and leap for joy, because great is your reward in heaven. For their fathers treated the prophets in the same way. Rejection will come. Persecution will come. But make sure you are not doing anything to earn such reactions. Ephesians 4:15. Instead, speaking the truth in love, we will in all things grow up into Christ Himself, who is the head. Ephesians 4:25. Therefore, each of you must put off falsehood and speak truthfully to his neighbor, for we are members of one another. Proverbs 15:1. A gentle answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. If you live a righteous life and stand for righteousness, the world will hate you. But just because the world hates you does not mean you are in a righteous position. There are things that will cause the world to revile you that are not righteous. As you take a stand, knowing the truth that the world desperately needs to hear, knowing that the strong delusion is all around, retarding those who do not love the truth, preserve your kind speech, loving speech, and truthful speech. We are approaching a time that is about you, preserving your salvation. I do not mean that in a selfish way, even though I recognize it can sound that way. I am speaking about preserving your heart and not letting bitterness or anger grow. Proverbs 4:23, guard your heart with all diligence, for from it flow springs of life. Matthew 15:18, but the things that come out of the mouth come from the heart, and these things defile a man. Luke 6:45, the good man brings good things out of the good treasure of his heart, and the evil man brings evil things out of the evil treasure of his heart. For out of the abundance or overflow of the heart, the mouth speaks. I'm preaching more to myself than you right now. Watching a slow-motion disaster and knowing it is coming is not really a fun position to occupy. Getting back to meta-thoughts about this series for a moment. First and foremost is the Holy Spirit you need to get to know in your own heart. John 14:26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I, meaning Jesus, have said unto you. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.